The clock is ticking for neighborhoods to sign up for Google Fiber. The deadline for signing up is midnight on Sunday. As of this Friday morning, 52 out of 74 neighborhoods, or fiberhoods as they're calling them by Google, in Kansas City, Kansas, have met the sign-up goal. On the Missouri side, 78 out of 128 fiberhoods have met the goal to take advantage of the 100 times faster internet service. Area schools, community centers, and libraries have a lot riding on all this. They'll get free Google Fiber if their neighborhood is wired. But if not enough people in their neighborhood sign up, then they're out of luck, and that's leaving some groups steaming that there's going to be a growing digital divide created, because Google Fiber's own map shows it's mostly the more lower-income areas, particularly east of Troost Avenue, that are struggling to enroll customers. That means their schools, their libraries, and community centers won't be getting access to the Google revolution. Now, since we first talked about this on the program a few weeks ago, has the gap been narrowing, though, Eric?
Not really. People in this Easter Truce that we've talked to, I did a story about it last week, or it costs too much, and there's not enough information about it. So they're not signing up. Some people said that they would rather keep the programs that they have now. Their internet is already fast enough, and it's not going to make that much difference. There's a lot of older people, don't have computers, don't have the things that go along with the system. So a lot of them are like, they're satisfied with what they have now. And another thing that people were saying, more so than not, was that they have bundled packages now. They have their cable, their internet and phone bill, and Google doesn't offer that, so they just keep everything they have and have one bill rather than have separate bills come to their house.
Now, Mary, you were giving a little bit of the benefit of the doubt that there was going to be this push of community leaders trying to work with, certainly on the east side neighborhoods, to try and get them signed up. Are you seeing that working out?
There's been some incredible, just in the streets, door-to-door work that has been done. And, you know, end of the day on all this, we'll see by midnight Sunday whatever, you know, what transpires. But people have really, really worked, and it's community leaders, to make this happen, to turn all these areas green. There was quite a bit of traffic that happened yesterday, even, in these spots where maybe they only needed like five more signups to occur, and that was happening. So I do think this weekend is going to be quite interesting to see how much can come through. There are still quite a few places, though, and some of them are a little surprising, like Quality Hill area. When I checked late last night, they still needed like more than 100. That includes MARC, Mid-America Regional Council, would be the entity that would get the public access. So it's not just people are thinking of schools and community centers. There are some other areas that haven't been able to get the sufficient numbers.
Stacy.
Someone's got to explain to me why Google's taking a hit for not narrowing the digital divide, because Google never came into Kansas City, Kansas, or Kansas City, Missouri, promising to do that. They said they would sign this service up, and it would be limited services to parts of the metro to where it was cost efficient to do it. They're running a for-profit business, so where they see it is profitable for them to come in and wire those communities, they're doing it. Now, they also promised to give access to the community libraries and other instances of that, schools, to where they've signed up. But in these neighborhoods where people aren't coming to the forefront, in an article I read said cost wasn't the problem.
Yes.
It was that people didn't understand the service. But Google is a private company. They're trying to turn a profit. We all understood that when they came in here, you know, what, 2 years ago now. So I don't understand why they're taking the hit. Someone's going to have to explain that.
Wasn't there the expectation, though, that they were going to provide free internet access to public entities like schools?
But it was always contingent on getting, I mean, it's their business model.
Yes.
And it's a financial one. They are a business.
Yes.
But they did discuss trying to breach this digital divide. They did do as that was one of their goals. Now, granted, they are a business. Their overall goal is it's a profit, and I have no problem with that.
Absolutely.
And
they are a private business.
If you look at it, though, they did make some real missteps. And if you say that you want, even from a business perspective, if you want to roll out something across a wide, vast disparities of demographics area, and your own business plan doesn't seem to address the differences within that area,
no, that's a good point, Eric.
$120 is a lot of money for internet and cable. Most people are getting it for $70 in a bundle package. So it is a lot of money. And a lot of people in the urban core that's on fixed incomes, most of the people in the areas that are by the schools are in fixed income areas, and they don't have $120 a month for internet speed.
But that's talking the highest service. They're still offering high-speed internet for $25 a month over the course of a year that will give it to you free, for the existence of it. So we're not talking about this
high...
Well, then they messed up in their marketing, but that isn't a point of them coming in with some type of bad intent, Google. They said from the beginning this is going to be a narrow corridor of service. Only those who signed up and would show that it was cost-effective for Google to run the lines would get the service, but now we're expecting that they should wire the whole city. And that just isn't, I don't think that's realistic.
Bill.
They did lower.
The wisdom of Solomon is now going to come down to you.
Well, they did lower the threshold because Kansas City has a great number of vacant lots and vacant houses, and so they redid the ratio on that, which does make it probably a little bit more accessible for folks, but it also doesn't look so good for Kansas City because it points out that we still have thousands of vacant buildings out there all over the place.